Do you know what they're serving at that one, though? Look, we don't. He's getting ready. I mean.
He's a hard son of a bitch to live with.
Hey, Pop, stop yelling at me. Hold on. It's 352.
You got to get one for
353-8665.
Hey, I want to take Dana out to eat, too.
I'm sorry. 352.
Yep. 353-8665.
Do they use the same oven for the food as they do for the cremation?
Okay, that's too many numbers. So 353-8665.
Just take one of them off.
I don't know. I'm trying to read his writing. He can't see her much, but hold on. Let me see. It's 352-353-8665.
Ask her if she knows the temperature in them ovens.
Okay, so that is the phone number.
He's wanting to know how hot the oven is. He going to feel anything?
That would be something the representative could answer.
I mean, I keep trying to tell him he's going to be dead. You know, he's probably not going to feel a damn thing once you're dead, right?
Okay, and the zip code, sir?
33729.
33729. And a guest that will be coming?
Yeah, we're going to bring several. I'd like to bring my son, his girlfriend, my daughter.
Could we just start with yourself?
Oh, of course. That's the most important one.
I can't bring the grandkids along.
Yeah, we're bringing everybody. Just shut up over there. God damn it, you keep interrupting me. You're going to be getting cremated sooner than you know it. I'm sorry, ma'am.
Hey. And your name, sir?
My name is Billy.
Long Billy. Billy.
And
he
your
wants
last
me to
name.
Change my name to. He wants me to change my name to Lonesome Billy. I'm not going to do it.
Isn't that a nice name?
Dad, shut
maybe,
up!
Maybe you can find a girl that can cook.
Stop it!
Sorry, sir. Could I have your last name, please?
Yes, Bob.
Billy Bob, B-O-B-B, and your telephone number, sir.
You just got this phone. It's a new phone.
What is your telephone number, sir?
352-353-8665.
Same number, 352-353-8665. Would that be the same zip code?
Holy shit, it is.
Mm-hmm.
All right. I never realized that before. All right, can I give you the rest of the information?
Well, that's all I really need for now, but you wanted to bring more people. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, I got like... I mean, it depends on what you guys are serving, but yeah, I probably got about 4 or 5, maybe 7 or 8. And
okay, let's see.
How many can I bring? Because
well, they only have a limited listing. So what I'll do is I'll send a message through to the person that's a rep.
I was thinking about just doing like a family reunion. Like this could be like his, you know,
going away party.
Yeah, yeah. We say.
And how many did you want to register?
Let's go. How many should we
don't,
register?
Don't invite that Kevin. He's a cheap prick.
Oh, for Kevin. I'm not bringing Kevin. The last time I came, he got drunk as shit.
Oh, okay.
I'm not bringing Kevin. Okay. Sorry about that. No, Kevin's not coming, so let's call it 12.
Our serving and would like to bring 12 people. To a seminar.
If we could get it on the one, if we could get it at the one on Catches on August 14th, that's his birthday. Do you think they'd sing happy birthday to him at the dinner?
I really don't know, sir.
I don't even know if he's going to make it that long, but
Hey, Jay, ask if Pops can get.
Okay, so I will get this message to them, and I have your phone number.
Wheelchair
the 352-353-8665.
All right. Hey,
thank you, sir.
All right, thanks a lot, dear. You're great.
Okay.
All right, bye.
Bye-bye.
Dude, that was their phone number, bro.
She's like, click.
And I told her she was alive and he has no hair. So it was totally legit. I did say it. You're live on the air.
Yeah. She accepted like 5 times.
Yeah.
Dude, PJ was asking me to ask you if you could get Pops a front row seat by the action.
Wheelchair accessible.
I should ask. Do they have demonstrations on how it goes down?
Yeah, that's when they cook the fish.
I don't know, man. I find much enjoyment in that. So
that's awesome. Give Pops,
Pops, how do you feel about that right now?
Let's give Pops a clap for you. Yeah.
Pops did good.
Awesome.
Normally, I'd say you shouldn't do that kind of shit.
No, he's pissed off right now because we just blew his opportunity at a free lunch.
No, he's booked. You booked the whole family. It's a family.
You should have asked if she was going to be there. She sounded kind of hot.
Yeah. Oh, yes. What's great about it is she actually put that through, so when that person gets
She put
thing,
notes in there, yeah.
She's like, okay, your number's 352. Oh, it's the same as yourself. Oh. So when the person gets the lead, they're going to be like,
some sales.
It's our freaking phone number, man. What's
some sales rep's going to be leaving a message on their own machine.
12 people.
that was great, man. That was great.
I'd love to call catches right now.
All right, call them up. Let's do it.
I'm going to have to
call
give
them
me a
up.
Minute.
Tell them you understand that they're going to be having this there at that date, and you want to know what they're going to be serving, and if they're going to use the same ovens
that's
for the
enough.
Fish.
That's enough. No, that's enough.
All right, Pop says that's enough. We'll do catches
Pop's
later.
Calling it.
All right. It's all good.
He gets all kinds of crazy mail, and
I get all kinds of crazy solicitations on the telephone too.
Yeah, Philbert gets solicitations as well on his way to work in St. Pete.
Allegedly,
everybody does.
Uh-oh, they're calling back. All right, the FCC's on right cord. Now.
Hold on. We have a live call here on the Kevin Holly Show. Hold on a second here.
All right.
You're live on the Kevin Holly Show. Who's this?
What's up, fuckers?
Oh, it's Derelict Daryl. Hi, Derelict Daryl.
Derelict Daryl, I haven't heard from him.
No, you were close.
What's his name? Dickalick Daryl?
Dickalick Daryl.
I got Gay Tony with me tonight.
It's Rob Haas.
It is Trucker Rob. Hey, Trucker Rob, before you say anything else, I want to play this intro for every time you call. Trucker Rob, part of the Kevin Holly Show, an eager listener, a truck driver.
Breaker.
Here we go.
Trucker Rob. Trucker Rob. Trucker Rob. Trucker Rob. Trucker Rob, drive a truck, Trucker Rob. Driving trucks is all he wants to do. Drive a truck, Trucker Rob. Driving trucks because he loves you.
Welcome to the show, bro. How the hell are you?
Oh, yeah, that was bad. Hell yeah. Can I make a request, though?
Sure.
Put an air horn in there.
No, I can't do that. Man, FCC regulations, man.
Yeah, man. Hey, man, I got your guys' swag pack, man. Thank you.
Oh, you're very welcome. How did you like it? Are you currently enjoying the swag pack that we sent you?
Oh, yeah, man. My favorite part of that old swag pack there, that's that old butt plug, man. It smelled like it come right out of Jay Bird's butt.
It did. It totally did.
I've used it a time or two. I do work in a Greek restaurant, so I missed it this
Opa.
Week.
Oh, God, Jaybird, come on now, man.
I missed it this week, dude. I hope you've had as much use out of it as I've needed it, but...
Oh, yeah, I got something in return for you, Jaybird. I got my old tongue ring in here. I'm fitting to go down probably here, probably on Friday. I'm going to go get one of those vibrating rings that goes in your mouth there for when I get a hold of that old butthole for you.
What did you just say?
What's happening here?
Are we on channel 19 right now?
Breaker, Warden 9. That's you lot awesome. Lizards. Breaker, Warden 9. You lot lizards. You're getting them in the back of my truck. You can come over here and get them in because I don't have my butt plug in tonight.
Can I get a 20 on Gay Tony?
Yeah, what's your 20, Gay Tony?
I've got his ass tied up in the back of the trailer back there at the truck. You know, he's running that old dick sucker again, and
The cocksucker.
I had to slap every dick he ever sucked right out of his mouth.
Hey, Trucker Rob, let me ask you something real quick here. Did you happen to receive the cum rag with Jaybird's face on it like you requested? Fuck, like you requested?
Oh, I did, buddy. Let me tell you what, I beat my dick about 10 times in 5 minutes on that son of a bitch.
Jesus.
I did. I'm breaking her in good, buddy.
That's awesome. Well, welcome back to the show. It's been a whole week, man. We missed you. I got really excited last night, and I made that Trucker Rob Shaka Khan thing. What? I'm scratching my balls, man. What, your balls are never itch? Well, your PJ's laughing at me.
Balls don't itch, you ain't got none.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Rob. That's what I'm talking about. Big Hoss in the house. Talking about how it's all right to scratch your nuts. Yeah, for real, though.
Hey, man, you scratch your nuts. That's all there is to it.
Hey, Rob, do you ever make deliveries to grocery stores?
I make deliveries to distribution centers.
Okay. Now, those distribution centers are associated to many different stores and whatnot, I'm sure. Have you ever delivered to, like, Winn-Dixie or Publix or anything like that?
No, not yet. I think the only two I remember doing is I've done Safeway, Albertsons, and Walmart. Those are about the only three I remember.
What about Aldi's?
Not yet. I've got a feeling that one's coming up pretty quick.
That's right. All these nuts in your mouth. Woo! Thank you. Thank you.
Well, obviously they're not all that much, but I'm still talking. You see what I'm saying? So hey. When you want to try that joke again, make sure they drop a little bit more so at least I get a mouthful of people.
Boom!
Kevin's never separated at birth, man.
That's Trucker Rob with the quickness.
So where is Trucker Rob right now?
I'm sitting here at the house holding this fucking couch to the floor. That's where I'm at today.
You're not on the road?
No, fuck no. I left out Monday and went down just the other side of Knoxville to drop this load I was under. And I got there and, you know, I was there like 7 o'clock in the morning. I was an hour early.
I'll drop a load.
The whole man said, hey, boss, I got in there and got checked in. They didn't have me on the schedule.
Trucker Rob, you ever get up there in Oregon?
Yep. Been to Oregon several times.
You pump your own gas while you're there?
Don't start.
It's a serious question.
No, man, I pay that little hooker $10 to pump my fuel for me.
How long does it take to gas up that big rig, man?
You hear his wife in the background. Like, you pay a hooker to do what for you?
Hold on.
What's your wife? Your wife's about to kick your ass in the background, man. What's going on?
I'm flirting with Jay Bird too much.
Is that a mandalay?
Yeah.
Hey, Rob, can we talk to her real quick?
Yeah, hold on.
All right. I love this guy, man. He's what's down her, for anything. Hello?
What's her show name?
Hey, girl, how's it going?
I'm going pretty good. How's it?
That's always good. Now, we want to come up with a name for you for the show. We got Trucker Rob and his wife. That doesn't sound right. That sounds like something out of Gilligan's Island, you know?
We could just call her wife.
No, we got to come up with a name for her. What's your maiden name and social security number?
Measurements, too.
And credit card number.
What? Do you have a nickname?
No.
Boss Hoss.
Boss Hoss?
No, I think he said Boss Hoss. Oh. That's the boss of the house, right? She wears the pants. Is that what you're saying,
Hoss?
I got
you. Yeah, okay. All right.
That's what he's saying. He knows.
Yeah, man, she wears the pants in this relationship, but what she don't realize is I control the zipper only when she tells me I can.
All right, that makes sense. let me ask you this, Hoss. Do you have a nickname for her? Like a bedroom name, like a sweetness name, like a pet name?
She calls me God, so I guess I call her boss lady.
You call her what?
I call her boss lady.
Oh, boss lady. All right.
I do whatever I want until she tells me not to.
So we'll call you Big Hoss, and we'll call her Big Boss.
Boss lady. Boss lady's
big
good.
Big boss lady.
Oh, yeah? We'll call her Boss Hoss.
Boss Hoss, Boss, that's fine.
Boss,
yeah.
And Rob Hoss.
You don't
yeah.
want to call a girl big anything. I mean, that's just rude. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah,
I've never seen her. I don't know from Adam. But, yeah.
I'm a homo.
Shut that dog up. Shut that Tony up. So, hey, Hoss, do you happen to have a human sized bird cage in the back of your truck?
You don't want to know the answer to that.
No, that's why I asked. What the fuck? Of course I want to know the answer to that.
Kevin
it's
wants.
Got my home swing in it.
Kevin wants to be locked up in it. That's why he's asking.
Free ride.
Yeah, I'll tickle Kevin's liver from the bottom side.
What? No. Wow.
If I'm going to shoot my dick so far up your ass, I'm going to touch you with the tip of my dick at the bottom of your lungs.
You could do that for Pops and clear him up a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, Pops. Sorry. Yeah. What? What'd I say?
Uh-oh. Kevin pissed Pops off and ain't looking good up here. Pops, put your gun away.
Yeah, put that down, Pops. There's no need for violence.
Pops, come on now, Pops. He ain't worth the bullet, man. That fucking bullet's too much money. Use a knife.
Wow.
That's all a $5 round you got in your hand. You can go to the dollar store to get a knife for a dollar.
For a dollar, yeah, like a steak knife. So, Rob, what are your plans for, like, the rest of the week? Are you off for the whole week? I mean, how do you do this? Are you gone for a week, home for a week?
Yeah, for 4 hours.
I'm playing lots of sex.
Yeah.
Lots of sex for now, yeah. But like I was saying before, anyhow, I was over there at my place, you know. I was up there at 7 o'clock. By about 10 o'clock, I was finally getting unloaded. And I got a hold of boss man. I said, hey, you motherfuckers are going to pay me for sitting here because my wheels ain't turning and I'm not making no fucking money. And they told me, no, they're not. So I told them, you can go back to the house and pick my fucking truck up and take it back with you.
Wow. So does that mean that you're open for new gigs now?
Oh, no. So I'm always open, honey. I'm always open.
All right. Because I got a work truck that I use for, it's my boss's truck, but, you know, I could use a driver, you know, so I can sit back and relax.
Okay, well, I know you're down there in Newport Richey, Florida.
Yes, sir.
I'm not going to end up like that truck driver down in San Antonio at the Walmart, am I?
Oh, man, I heard about that, dude. He had like, dude, think about that, man. If you're a professional truck driver, whether you own your own rig or if you're using it for work, from work, that guy had like 30 or 50 humans in the back of the truck coming back from Mexico and into San Antonio, Texas, not San Antonio, Florida, which is not far from us at all. But I guess like two people escaped at a Walmart parking lot and then they went inside to get water. And that's how the guy got busted. And they found like 8 dead people in the back. Like they were just sweating and dying. It was like, and that guy's going to jail.
As of Friday, that number jumped up to number 10.
Number 10 people dead. Now, that guy's going to prison for like 30 or 50 years or something like that for human trafficking and homicide. Now, what if he didn't know what was in the... I guess all truckers need to know what's in the back of their load, right? I mean, that's like part of the rules.
Yeah, you've got your load manifest with you and all that. Now, the guy knowingly knew that they were back there. See, where he was coming from down in Laredo, Texas...
Oh, I went out there.
Either which way you go to get out of Laredo, Texas, you've got Border Patrol checkpoints.
Tell Rob, tell his woman to shut the hell up.
Yeah, tell your wife to shut the fuck up, will you please? He's not going to do it.
He's like,
he won't do it.
He was so nice about it. Next thing, if he would have said... Now, wait, let's hear from the slap. Let's wait to hear the slap.
Before you get there, talk to that cop, that old border cop. He says, are you American? You say yes. Anybody with you, yes or no? Prior to all of that, you've got a little sensor that's on each side of your trailer. And as you drive through that little sensor, it takes heat images of what's in your trailer. So they can see what's inside of your trailer, even if you don't know.
Right, so...
I mean,
what if you're dead and cold?
There wasn't nothing in there, obviously. It's so like, he had to have known those people were in there.
It's hot as an oven back there.
Oh, it's hotter than the gates of hell in July back there.
So is he guilty of negligence or murder? Murder.
Hey, I got
I don't know. I just call it both.
I got one thing to say that is really sadder than the fact that, you know, there was 10 people that died in the back of the trailer, is the fact that there was actually 100 of them in there. So it could have been a lot. It could have been a lot better.
Yeah, Jesus, yeah. It really could have. That just made that 90. That means there's just 10 less that ain't coming over.
He just made Pops laugh. Jesus, dude.
That's about 80 people there. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah. All right, Hossel, I'm glad that you didn't get caught doing that. I mean, you're not going to do that anymore, are you?
This is on live. I'm going to go ahead and plead the fifth on that.
Do you think that trucker, let's say nobody died, do you think he gets paid based on how many people actually survive when he arrives at his destination?
Yeah, like a dollar a head or something.
Like if you're like a wolf and you're taking these people over and it doesn't matter if they make it alive or not, maybe we should go into business doing that. Number one, we get paid. Number two, we lower the immigration rates by letting them die in the back of it.
Wow, Phil, that's
a lucrative business.
Brilliant, man. Wow.
Either way you look at it, you get more from dead than you do alive.
You guys are horrible.
How much do you think you could make if you smuggled 100 Mexicans in a trailer? I mean,
how do you know they were Mexican, Jay? Are you assuming their gender?
El Salvador, whatever, illegal immigrants. How much do you think?
The goddamn border jumping beaner spick motherfuckers.
Jesus Christ!
Me personally, I do about 20,000 a head.
Wow, he is a trucker.
You think that much?
He is a trucker.
I don't think that much.
Disclaimer: you should probably play right.
Yeah, we already have all that. Yeah, this is all hyperbole, satire.
You got these guys that kidnap these girls and make them work as sex slaves. Them girls that are going to them teenage girls, they make anywhere between $15,000 and $20,000 in a week.
A week.
I think they're willing participants, though. I mean, you see them hanging out.
I'm in the wrong business.
Was Big Hoss one of those girls at one time?
Big Hoss don't mess with those girls, huh?
This big bosses, or I mean, Hoss boss is listening right now.
I know. I'm asking.
He can't agree to
that.
Yeah,
man. Yeah, you're trying to get me, huh? You're trying to get me in trouble up here.
Listen to her in the background. She just said that Kevin Holly. It's Holly, the Kevin Holly show.
Yeah. She said Kevin Howley.
Holly.
That's Hawaiian for white person.
It's H.
Yeah, but you have to dig yourself a grave.
I got about 100 Mexicans I'll put in it for you.
Hey, forget that, man. We're going to a dinner at Ketch's in 2 weeks. Just come.
You guys want to come?
You bring 100 Mexicans to that.
No, we don't need the services. They're already taken care of. We're here for the food.
Yeah, right. All right, Hoss, we're going to let you go, man. We got to get into our last segment here for the second hour.
All
right, fellas, man. You guys take it easy. Peace out. You keep her sunshine up and keep them fucking legs closed. Jay Bird, I'll be looking for you when I get down there, baby.
All right, I'll be ready for you.
Hell yeah.
You bet. Don't grab no pillows. I don't use Vaseline. I'm just going to go in raw and I'm just going to hit it hard, all right?
Raw nugget. Raw nugget.
Wow.
All right, fellas, y'all take it easy. I'll holler at you next week now.
Trucker Rob, everybody.
Trucker Rob. Trucker, 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 trucker Rob. Trucker Rob. Trucker Rob. Trucker Rob, Trucker Rob, drive a truck, Trucker Rob. Driving trucks is all he wants to do. Drive a truck, drive a truck, drive a truck, Trucker Rob. Driving trucks because he loves you.
I think that's awesome, dude. I don't know why. It's so stupid. Anyway, so I think we should get into some real news, man, real quick here. I got a couple of news things pulled up here. I think it's time that we do this before Jay and Pop's probably going to take off for the... leave me and Phil here alone for the third hour.
They can't leave before the pyramid, dude.
Yeah, we'll play the pyramid game, too. Should we do that first?
Yeah, let's do that and then leave weird news for you guys to do. Cause
sounds good. All right, ladies and gentlemen.
You guys can't do the pyramid by yourself.
No, that would be
that
weird.
That would be weird. Would
totally I'm a pyramid virgin. I don't know what goes on here.
It's the pyramid game, Phil.
I made a list, though. I did make a list.
The $100,000 pyramid. It's where you give clues, and they have to guess the word.
I'm going to have to Google that.
Only on the Kevin Holly show, it's the 50 cent pyramid.
Shit, I don't even have that. All right,
it's
are you
the
ready?
Five dimes pyramid.
Hold on, let's take Phil off this feed here.
You get 10 cents per question.
Let's get a little jaybird on that. Here we go. Can he see you on there? Maybe I'll turn a little bit more.
Hey, watch it, man. You're going to knock the water over.
Don't knock the water over,
Don't knock the water over.
Don't knock the water over.
Sorry, man.
You said it.
All right, it is time for the pyramid game.
Hey, hold on, wait. Everybody's left, dude. I think Trucker Rob scared him out, dude.
No, we got Glick, Seth Gecko, Captain Buttmunch.
Is it re-upping in my computer?
I don't know.
Glick's in there twice.
Glick says that this is 90s radio. Is this going to be Jerky Boys, says Captain Buttmunch?
I think they left us, dude. They don't like us anymore,
He says that PJ is going to gargle Pops' balls.
What?
Let me in on that.
All right, are you guys ready for the $100,000 pyramid game live on the Kevin Holly Show? Here we go. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the game where we ask a series of questions. There's a new twist to this game, Jay Bird, Pops, Philbert. After you do the five questions, you'll have a bonus question, which will be guess the topic or subject matter of the five questions. Like last week we did cars, remember? So after you answer all the questions, then you can have the bonus question. What is the subject of these questions? Are you ready for this? We got 30 seconds on the board. Pops, I think you're going to be the one asked first. Sound good?
So who's asking them?
Philbert, you got five questions there for Pops, right? You got to give him clues. You can't say the words. Okay?
Oh, wait a minute, man. You set me up. You didn't tell me I had to, like...
All right, we'll let Jay Bird go
first.
You just
told me to write words down.
Here, I'll show you how it happens.
Why don't you quiz Philbert first?
I didn't write five... You didn't.
I put five questions right there for you.
Oh, really?
Fuck yeah.
I got two sets of five questions here.
Cool. I thought this was
the second
one's
for me, Phil. The ones you wrote. All right, here we go. Jay Bird, Philbert, live pyramid game on the Kevin Holly Show. 30 seconds on the board.
Okay, when I masturbate, I clean it up with a...
Kleenex?
No, sometimes people use them to wipe the floor.
Mop.
Do their dishes with it. It's clothes.
Sponge.
But it's, women use them to stop themselves from bleeding. They call it...
A tampon?
No, but it's...
Maxi pad.
No, it's... it's a kind of a bad word for what women are on when they're...
A rag.
There you go.
Holy shit, he got it the last second. At the buzzer. Woo! Nicely done, Phil. All right, 30 seconds on the board. Question two.
Oh, this is so fucked up, dude. All right, same subject, but it's a little nicer word for what women use when they're on the thing. Sometimes they use it to cover their thing when they're bleeding.
A shield?
But there's a different word for
it. Says shield.
Did I already say it? Pad?
There you go.
Whoa, Philbert.
Okay, and the amount of blood that comes out of the vagina is also called the...
Flow.
Thank you. And...
I know a lot about vaginas, man. Keep it coming.
What they do is when they are
menstruating.
On their menstrual cycle, they...
Bitch.
Yes, but they also, like if you cut yourself, you're going to...
Bleed.
There you go.
Whoa!
This one is really bad. It's one of Kevin's friends. It's our friend. He's been on the show before. He's written
Click.
A book. He's written a book. He, I think your sister is helping him edit it.
I know his name, but I can't pronounce it.
Yeah, but this is his nickname. This isn't his real name.
Pussy?
It seems like he
Come
might
on, help
be,
me out here. Help
it,
me out.
I don't even know how to say it, dude. This is really messed up question, Kevin. It's his nickname that if you haven't heard it, you ought to listen to the show.
Got it wrong, man.
Oh, man, you ruined my streak.
But you know what's messed up, though?
It's like...
He's on the phone right now.
Is he?
Hi, you're live on the Kevin Holly Show. What's your name?
Dude, the Kevin Holly Show keeps repeating. And it doesn't get any better the second or third time.
It's Pat Shit Crazy calling in live on the Kevin Holly Show.
That was the answer.
Pat Shit Crazy, I would not have guessed that.
Damn.
I know.
So what's up, Pat?
Dude.
Do I get the bonus question?
What? I'm listening to the Kevin Holly Show.
Right.
Streaming on Spreaker.
Uh-huh.
But it keeps repeating.
Well, get a better phone.
Call your ISP.
Wait a minute. What's he
saying? No, it's not an... It's weird. Is anybody else having this issue?
I haven't heard a word.
Something's going on.
Something's
because
going on.
Nobody...
haven't heard a word.
Haven't heard the word.
Haven't heard a word.
The bird's a word.
Nobody's said anything in the chat room for like 30 minutes.
Nobody said anything in the chat room for like 30 minutes, so.
Other than me.
They probably left 30 minutes. But when shit started falling apart.
Maybe.
So when...
So get rid of the echo.
What do you keep...
Ow! I hit my head!
What do you
Are you guys serious, though? There's not a...
What do you keep hearing? What do you keep hearing? You say it's repeating.
What do you keep hearing? You say it's repeating?
Like the introduction to the show? And no. Then, of course, I heard Pops telling the story, repeating the story about...
Now I know why you guys call him batshit crazy.
About August 7th?
Oh, yeah, we're having a party.
August
you want to come?
7th.
Yeah.
No, but he repeated that same thing. Repeated.
It was
again.
August 5th, 55 years ago, 1962.
August 5th.
Do you not know math? Oh.
I don't. Not as well as you.
Thank you, Pops. See, I'm a mathematician.
But so, I swear that that's what I just listened to 5 minutes ago as I was pulling into the parking lot. Should I have heard that?
No.
No.
Sounds like a buffering problem.
Sounds like a buffering
Is
problem.
Is there something you could be... See, I mean, I heard it 2 hours ago when I started listening.
Has it been repeating since you've been on this phone call?
Has it been repeating since you've been
I don't
on this
know
phone
because,
call?
I don't know because I can't listen to it while I'm on my phone. I was streaming it through my phone.
So, wait a minute here.
Yeah, this is...
It's a perplexing conundrum.
That's okay. Jaybird, you're looking at the Facebook Live on that little device there in your hand.
I know, but okay. I'm just trying to see what everybody's saying here.
I don't know. Well, listen.
I mean,
now.
I would look at that as like a bonus.
Pat, how the hell are you, man? I only got a couple of minutes before a hard break.
I'm doing great. I know it is. Well, aren't you guys... Oh, no, you're like 2 hours into the show. You got another hour.
Yeah.
You guys are having a break. I'm downstairs. I just dropped off a passenger.
Sweet! I'll see you in like less than 5 minutes. No, we're going to take a break in a minute.
Okay.
Yeah, see you in five minutes, Pat. All right.
All right.
Cool. Well, how about that? Patch it crazy downstairs.
So back to this. I get a bonus question, right?
Yeah.
I'm supposed to somehow like tell you that all of these questions had something to do
with the subject,
which Kevin didn't tell me. So none of my questions are like related to each other. None of the things I wrote for my thing. So Kevin, you don't get a bonus when I do mine.
Okay.
But I'm trying to figure out how freaking his nickname has anything to do with the other stuff.
Kevin's nickname?
No, Pat Bergdahl.
So has nothing to do with everything else.
He called
else.
Him Bergdahl.
Whatever it is. I don't know what it is.
It has nothing to do. It just has to do with
Berg,
the first
with
four.
Hey.
And we said the words. So.
Menstrual cycles.
Well, we got it.
Yeah.
Boom. All right, listen.
Up for it.
Before we do anything else, I would like to thank our IRN Internet Radio Network, IRNBroadcast.com listeners. Thank you to Lionel Nation listeners for sticking around and listening to our show. Stay tuned for The John LeBang Show, which is coming up next. Also, catch our next replay Friday morning, 8 a.m. on the IRN. Thanks for listening, IRN listeners. We will catch you again next Wednesday night live at 8 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. Friday morning, 8 a.m. morning drive. Saturday, 3 p.m. Eastern Time to 6 p.m. And again, Monday nights at 3 a.m. they're playing us. Pretty cool. 3 a.m.
Or just keep listening. We repeat, apparently.
Yeah, apparently we repeat. And also, if you want to continue to listen to our show and you're on the IRN, go over to Spreaker.com/The Kevin Holly Show and get in the chat room or call us up 727-237-6010. We're going to take a hard break and come right back with more of The Kevin Holly
Show.
Yeah,
Kevin's going to take a hard break, all right.
Hey.
I think something's going wrong here. What? Yeah.
I don't know what you want to do with that.
What do you want to do with that?
Drink it.
All right, we'll be right back with more of The Kevin Holly Show. In just a few minutes after these words.
The only show on the radio where you can smell Nall's balls. The Kevin Holly Show.
You must die. I alone am best.
I clutching the bottle fed must be. And we can't forget the newlyweds. And those Jerry's kids are as good as dead. I hope this helps to emphasize. I hope this helps to clarify. I hope you die.
Listening to the Kevin Holly Show. Scott Butler and Kevin Holly and everyone else.
Every morning I get up before that rooster crows. Headed straight to somewhere I don't even want to go. Eggs and bacon in my belly and a Folgers coffee buzz. Good old radar detector, it protects me from the fuzz. Well, I do what I gotta do to get through working at 9 to 5. It's killing me, but then again, it's keeping me alive. It puts the gas in my truck, butter on my biscuit. Couple bucks when I'm itching for scratch off ticket. That poker makes me broker every Saturday night. But I still got running water and they ain't cut off the lights. Come Friday night, my friends and I start peeling off them labels. Working hard all week, put some beer on the table. $18 an hour and $1 million tan. All them women whistle at me while I'm working for the man. Making me some cold hard cash out in that summer sun. Come Friday I'll have money, but by Monday I'll have none. Once the bills are paid and that basketball tank is gone from E to F, I fill that big old cooler up, there ain't a whole lot left. But I got gas in my truck, butter on my biscuit. Couple bucks when I'm itching for a scratch off ticket. That poker makes me broker every Saturday night. But I still got running water and they ain't cut off the lights. Come Friday night, my friends and I start peeling off them labels. Working hard all week, puts the beer on the table. Some butter on my biscuit, couple bucks when I'm itching for a scratch-off ticket. That poker makes me broker every Saturday night. But I still got running water and they ain't cut off the lights. Come Friday night, my friends and I start peeling off them labels. Working hard all week, yeah. puts a beer on the table. But y'all pass me another one of them Coke cans.
You had the beers with you. You keep the fucking beers with you, but they don't last very fucking long.
Have you ever watched the sun go down and you're thinking about the world spinning round? Have you ever been high as fuck? You're in the bathroom mirror talking to yourself and your dog's looking at you like you need help. Have you ever been high as fuck? Then you feel your heart pumping really fast and you're convinced that you're gonna have a heart attack. Have you ever been high as fuck? Close your eyes and you're on a chicken farm. The only problem's that the chickens have human arms. You say that's fucked up, why do the chickens have human arms? You need snacks so you walk to the corner store, but you're scared because you think that they will know you're high. So you walk around the block to buy some time. Finally decide to go in the store, but you're so high you don't know why you're there anymore. So you just buy a pack of gum, get the hell out of there. You're walking home and your mouth is dry. You should have bought some juice and snacks, but you were too high. Thinking about ketchup chips, and for some reason the game Battleship. You start thinking about how fun it was to play games like Battleship when you're a kid, and how as we get older we forget how to play and just to enjoy ourselves. So you say, guess what, I'm gonna make up a game right now, and it involves a baseball bat and a porcupine, and I'm gonna try to kill a porcupine with a baseball bat. But then you don't know where to find the porcupine, so you go on eBay and you do a search, but people don't sell porcupines on the internet. And you say, you know what, world, you got me cornered again, I'm gonna roll another joint. You ever eat a whole bag of crackers that was so old that they weren't crispy anymore? Have you ever been high as fuck?
It's Jaybird in the morning. Shaquille O'Neal, Charles Barkley, Gold Bond, take 248 and action.
Hi, this is Shaq Diesel. I'm a spokesman for Gold Bond for Cream. God damn it. I fucked it up. Can we do that again?
Man, this is ridiculous. Shaq, you can't do nothing right.
Yo, shut up, Barkley. I'm gonna get it right this time.
Cut. All right. Shaquille O'Neal, Charles Barkley, Gold Bond, and take 285 and action.
The Shaq Diesel for Gold Bond foot powder. I love Gold Bond foot powder. So does my good friend Charles Barkley.
Man, you'd be stupid not to get yourself the Gold Bond foot powder. Don't be ridiculous.
Yeah, don't be ridiculous. Oh, God damn it. We'll do it one more time. I promise I'll get it right. Shaq's gonna get it right.
Cut. All right. Shaquille O'Neal, Charles Barkley, Gold Bond foot powder, and take 286 and action.
Hi, I'm Shaq Diesel for Gold Bond foot powder. Be like me and put that foot powder cream on your feet, fool. Don't be an asshole like Charles Barkley.
Man, that's ridiculous, Shaq. Man, that's terrible. Terrible.
Man, you're terrible, Barkley. I'll let you start this one. We'll get it right this time.
Yeah, let me start this one. You're terrible. You're ridiculous.
Cut. Okay. All right. Gold Bond. Shaquille O'Neal. Charles Barkley. Take 287. And action.
Man, don't be ridiculous. Be like me, Charles Barkley. And get yourself some of that Gold Bond foot cream powder for your feet. Even my man Shaq Diesel used that stuff because he not ridiculous. That's right. I'm Shaq Diesel. I use Gold Bond foot powder cream on my feet all the time. It makes them feel good. Makes them feel real good. So be like Shaq Diesel and put that shit on your feet.
Yeah, don't be ridiculous. Cut. That's a wrap.
Jay heard Pops today to see if he'd still feel. Pops focused on the pain, and then he had a beer. These people in studio, that old familiar sting, try to kill them all away, but I remember everything. What has Jay become? My sweatiest friend. Everyone Jay knows turns gay in the end. And Jay could have it all. My empire of work. Kev will let you down. Will make you hurt. I wear this crown of thorns on my tiny chair, full of stupid thoughts that Pops cannot repair. Beneath the sands of time, the reasoning disappears. Jay loves someone else. I am still right here. What has Jay become? My sweatiest friend. Everyone Jay knows turns gay in the end. And Jay could have it all. My empire of work. Will let you down. Kev will make you hurt. If I could start again, a million miles away, I would blow myself. I would find a way.
Oh, is she showing you pictures of Kevin naked over there?
Yeah, you want to buy one?
We'll be right back.
call now to the Kevin Holly Show at this number plus this number plus this number. And ask for Chuck.
This radio person is the whole problem. Are we going to allow this guy to be heard by anyone who can turn a dial?
He's got a pirate radio station. Nobody knows who he is.
You out there? You listening?
Want now. Well, the AC's got to be on. Welcome back to the Kevin Holly Show, everybody. We are live for the third hour here on Spreaker.com. If you're trying to listen on the app, the app's having a problem, but the regular Spreaker.com website's working just fine. So welcome back, everybody. Oh, hold on. There we go. So, yeah, welcome back to the Kevin Holly Show. Third hour. Oh, we're just going to kill it here. Wow, it looks like it restarted, man. Look at that. 2 hours or something.
Anybody left in the chat room?
No, the whole Spreaker app just restarted. I don't know what's going on with that, dude.
Well, for this entire last hour of the show, I would like to invite anybody who wants to ask questions in the chat room or call directly. Go ahead and ask your questions about Kevin Holly, and I will give you honest answers as his brother. Anything's open game, fair game. Just go ahead, formulate your questions.
I don't think it's going to happen, dude. I don't think anybody's in the chat room because the whole feed reset.
Well, they need to get in the chat room, and they need to start asking questions.
You know what's going to have to happen is I'm going to have to go back tomorrow at some point and download whatever little episodes or tidbits are up there. And splice it all together and make a three-hour show so they can replay it. So, none of those mouses work there, Phil. You got to use this right here. So I do have some strange news and some Facebook Live. Facebook Live is a segment that I like to play on this show where I save things throughout the week that I see on Facebook, but I don't click on them. So it's like headlines and things like that. And then I just read them out during the show. And it's part of our news segment, and here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is now time.
It is now time
for strange news on the Kevin Holly Show. Kevin Holly Show. Kevin Holly Show. Kevin Holly Show.
You like that?
Like it.
All right. Well, I have no concept of time now because all the clocks are different because our stuff reset. Ugh, I hate that. That's okay. We'll muscle through it. I don't know what the hell happened. All right, so here's our first story tonight, Philbert. A goat goes missing after walking off a goatscaping job. What do you think about goatscaping? Are you familiar with that term?
I mean, there is a small sector, you know, small business. There is profit to be made in goatscaping, and because believe it or not, they are somewhat self-conscious about their looks. Mm-hmm. So a well-groomed goat is a happy goat.
Yeah, and when you think about, like, people that you know, their culture is about goats, you know, they probably want their goats well-groomed.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I think this is a little different. I'm thinking more like lawn mowing service, you know? Like you just put up a fence and have some goats and they just eat the grass. Goats.
That makes too much sense.
Yeah. Well,
you could be onto something.
In Warwick, Rhode Island, police in Rhode Island are asking people to be on the lookout for a goat that wandered off a landscaping job.
You sure you didn't click on this before?
I'm positive, dude. So they get a
How
goat.
How do they get a goat back that's wandered away like that? Do they, like, leave a notebook, crumpled up notebook paper trail back to a pen, or?
Maybe. Like a tuna can, a trail of tuna cans.
Well, they like to chew on stuff. They eat tuna?
They chew on tuna cans, probably. Do you remember the goat song from Adam Sandler?
I do remember that goat song.
He's like,
I'm a simple goat.
Yeah, and he was like eating a tuna can.
Was he?
If I remember correctly. Anyway, Warwick police say the goat, which goes by the name Sammy, the names Sammy and Frank. So he's got multiple personalities, this goat. That's probably why he wandered off, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, he's bipolar. He's a bipolar goat. So he turned up missing during a post-work head count on Tuesday. How many goats do they have? They got to do a head count? So he's owned by the Goatscaping Company. That's all capitals. The Goatscaping Company, based in Plimpton, Massachusetts. Massachusetts has the best names for cities. Plimpton. Yeah, it.
I'm still stuck on this whole Goatscaping thing, and can I get that kind of service where I live, and what kind of things come with that service? I mean, do I have to worry about cleaning up afterwards? Do they clean up afterwards? Do they only do lawns?
No, they fertilize it. If they poop in your yard, it's fertilizer, you know? And I plus, mean, their little paws, like their hoofs, just mash it into the ground, you know?
So they aerate the lawn while they're walking around?
And they're eating it, too, so it's nicely trimmed, you know? Nicely trimmed. So it turned up missing, and Plimpton ain't easy, Phil.
Plimpton ain't easy, no. Especially if you're a schizophrenic goat.
Yeah, so Goatscaping, believe it or not, offers an alternative to herbicides in the management of vegetation. That's just off the top of my head, you know. But anyway, police say that he has one curly horn,
mm-hmm.
and he's small, brown, and generally funny looking. So, and I mean, most
funny like you when you see him, you'll laugh or
funny how?
Yeah.
How's that goat funny?
You know? Yeah, he tells jokes.
He's
and
got
stuff.
A fucking curly horn. He's super funny. Look at him.
Aren't all goat horns kind of curly?
I don't know.
Or are those just like those Pakistanian like mountain goats?
I'm not sure. I don't know a lot about goats, man. Now, lamb. I know a lot about lamb, you know. But goats, I don't know. Anyone who spots a goat roaming in the Warwick Neck area or anywhere else in Warwick is asked to call the Warwick Police Department. So, we got that going for us.
Interesting story.
Yeah.
Next.
Let's do a Facebook save story, shall we? Here we go. Let's see what I got here. And,
it's going to be hard to top the goat one, dude.
I don't know, man. Let's see here. Okay, here we go. Authorities say that an escaped inmate kidnapped the warden's stepdaughter, who was only 18 years old,
mm-hmm.
and stabbed her to death.
Yeah. Wow. Which is a shame, because I think I saw this, and she was pretty hot. It's kind of like a wasted warden daughter right there.
Yeah, I mean, a warden's daughter.
They could have done a lot of things. Like, if you're an escapee,
yeah.
and you've got the warden's daughter, you can, like, you pretty much got whatever you're asking for right there. Mm. And he just wasted it by stabbing her. Not really smart.
I agree. This came out of Baton Rouge, Louisiana. A prisoner abducted and killed an assistant warden's teenage stepdaughter after he escaped from a Louisiana prison. Authorities said that the inmate was later found dead after a standoff with police. So,
fancy that.
His name was Deltra Henderson. Guilty.
Yep.
He's 39 years old. He walked away from his prison assignment at David Wade Correctional Center on Thursday afternoon, stole a car, and then kidnapped Amanda Carney, the Claiborne parish.
Let that be a lesson.
Yeah.
To the owner of the Plimpton Goat Lawn Service. Hopefully he doesn't have a teenage daughter.
Yeah, exactly. You know? So, man, this is just too sad of a story. I'm not going to talk about the girl, but Henderson stole a second vehicle and then he crashed it before he entered a nearby home on prison property, found a gun, then he barricaded himself inside after a gunfight with prison guards, and then police found his body inside the home after the standoff ended. So at least he was fatally wounded, you know.
Justice.
Justice was served. Damn, though. But you can't, you know. All right, here's a better story. Much, much more positive, okay? From worldnewsdailyreport.com, which is a very reputable site, this woman was arrested for emasculating her cheating husband with her teeth.
Ooh.
St. Louis, Missouri. Ugh, fucking Cardinals fans. A 43-year-old woman was arrested this morning by the St. Louis Police Department after she tore off her husband's genitals with her own teeth as an act of vengeance for an alleged infidelity.
I mean, maybe he deserved it.
Look at that face, though.
Yeah, she's only 43, huh?
Damn. Now, is that hit it or quit it right there? Would you hit that or?
I mean, for the crazy factor, you'd pretty much have to hit that.
No.
Yeah, you would. No, you would.
She looks like a female Charles but Manson.
It might be wise to hit that from, like, behind, as far away from the mouth as possible, because she, yeah.
Well, during her interrogation, Christina Palmer Anderson confessed that she had been planning her crime since she had surprised her husband performing oral sex on her crystal meth dealer last weekend. I hope that the meth dealer is a female. She told police that she had spent many hours sharpening her teeth with a nail file over the last week.
Man, you got to like her dedication, though. I mean, she planned it, right? And then she took action. She didn't deviate from her plan at all. She executed it. I mean, I don't know. Maybe this is a crime of passion. They should probably be lenient on her.
How many hours does it take to sharpen your teeth?
Yeah, exactly.
Wow. So she finally put her plan into action this morning and began by tying her husband's hands and feet to their bed.
While he slept or while he was awake?
No, she said it was pretending that it was part of a sexual game.
She fooled him.
Mm-hmm.
Sucker.
Typical chick. So in an astonishing feat of jaw strength, she then cut through her husband's genitals.
Is it really an astonishing feat, though?
I mean, yeah. I mean, you eat chicken wings.
I mean, you've got some experience in that realm. It doesn't take much to put a dent in that area. Or a chip.
Oh, what's that?
Chip.
So she tore his penis and testicles from his body with her teeth, with her sharpened teeth. She then left him there, severely bleeding, to go in another room of the residence and smoke drugs.
I'm going to ask the question that's on everyone's mind. Mm-hmm. What happened to the torn-off genitals?
The victim, 47-year-old John Maurice Anderson, was fortunately able to untie himself in a matter of minutes and call 911 before he finally lost consciousness. The police and paramedics arrived a few minutes later and rapidly arrested Miss Anderson and transported her husband to the St. Louis University Hospital. When the police officers arrived on the site, the victim was naked, unconscious, and covered in blood, says Police Chief John Belmer. The accused was sitting on a couch smoking crystal meth with her face and clothes full of blood. She immediately confessed to castrating her husband, screaming, "I bit his dick off! I bit his dick off!" That's what she was screaming, dude.
But does it go on to say whether or not they were able to surgically reattach them? Or?
Well, she kept saying it over and over again and bragging about it. So
detachable penis.
She's now facing charges of first-degree domestic assault and attempted manslaughter, as well as possession of drugs and drug paraphernalia. However, she will have to undergo a complete psychiatric evaluation before her trial can begin. Her husband was put in an artificial coma and remains in critical condition, but the doctors are watching him and no longer fear for his life. I can't speak anymore. It's reconstructive surgery, it says here, so they must have found the penis and genitals.
Science,
man. I mean,
it's amazing.
Could he join the military without all that? Is he transgender? Yeah,
that's a gray area right there. I don't know about that. Dude, but the question is, do you want him to join the military? Will he be in the right state of mind to defend this country after an episode like that?
I don't know, man. I mean, he could be really angry. He could really take out a lot of terrorists.
Yeah, what if he was, fighting against female people on the other lines? Would he be extra mean to them? Or?
Yeah, like he's a sniper and he's only taking out women?
Exactly.
Well, I hear you, man.
And saying stuff while he's, taking them out, like, "This is for my dick!" Rat-a-tat-tat.
This is for my dick! Right? Just like that.
Reconstruct this, bitch!
Oh, we're getting a call here. Hold on a second.
Hopefully that's not mom.
Why? Oh, it's Jaybird. Hold on. Let me put him on speaker here. Jaybird, you're live in the air, man. You just left. What's up?
I forgot, something that I wanted to talk about, dude.
Okay.
Did you guys see the story where in Holiday, Florida, a dude stabbed a woman to death there?
Yes, we did.
You saw that?
Yep. Homicide.
Homicide. What happened, Jay? I didn't click on it.
You didn't click it?
No, I didn't click it yet.
The dude had been arrested. He was like 71 years old, and he'd been arrested twice before for murder.
Yep.
Wow. One was manslaughter, one was something like, he was arrested in like 63 and did like 20 years or something, and then did another one in like 99, and he was on probation. But I guess like part of what I want to do is say to our viewers, because cost is getting up there in years, so if you ain't want anybody murdered, I'm probably willing to pimp out Pops, dude.
Yeah, what has he got to lose now?
Yeah.
He's not gonna do a lot of time for it, right?
Right.
No, if he does do a lot of time, I mean, it's three hots and a cot, man.
Yeah, absolutely. You gotta take care of him, his medicines, all that shit, breathing treatments.
He gets away from you for a while.
It's probably cheaper. It's probably gonna be cheaper than like going to a nursing home or something.
What about
like the same care? So
what about cremation? What about cremation, sir? What about cremation services and meals?
Well, we're gonna wait until after that freaking dining fiasco. But I'm just saying, if anybody out there listening, Rob Haas, I know you hate that old lady you're with.
But serious question, Jay.
If you got somebody, I know you got a lot of kids. Whatever it is.
Serious question, though, Jay.
What?
Serious question, though. Wasn't that woman only like 43 years old?
Yeah, she was.
Can Pops handle a 43-year-old, or do we need to set, like, parameters around what he can and can't murder?
Well, no, I'm going to do the murder, but I'm just going to put the knife in his hands, and we're going to stick it to Pops. So. I could probably go as young as 38, so.
Well, hey, Jaybird, after the body's dead and still warm, are you going to fuck it?
Depends what she looks like, Kevin. That's an obvious question to start off, but, you know. No, of course I'm not going to fuck it.
Well, I thought...
That's not fucking her.
Okay. What about, like, a hand job?
Why would it have to be a woman? Why couldn't I kill a dude?
What are you trying to say?
Matt.
I'm not going to fuck a dude.
No comment.
All right. Obviously, this is why I left the show.
Oh, fuck. All right, man. I'll talk to you tomorrow.
Anything else you forgot?
I'm in my yard right now. I got some lawn work to take care of, so.
Anything else you forgot to mention?
Should get a
goat. We should cover?
I did put Pops' dolls up in his room already.
Yes.
So they look at him. You're going to be looking at him every morning while he eats his oatmeal or eggs or whatever.
I've been walking around with his balls in my pocket, and every step I take, they jingle, and I giggle every time.
Hey, Jaybird, Pixar didn't happen. I want to see pictures of those dolls while Pops is sleeping, all nestled up, cuddled up with him in his bed.
I should do that. Is that exploiting the elderly? Can I get in trouble for that? I don't know.
Make sure he sees the back tattoo on me, on my doll.
I saw it when I opened him up. That was pretty good.
What, you have a back tattoo, like a tramp stamp?
On the doll.
Yeah, it's a straight up right down the back. It's for Pops. There's a bunch of stuff, dude. Mary. There's a, I think the one on their arm, doesn't it say, JH or KH and JP or something like that on it?
The Pops doll says I love PJ, and the PJ doll says I love Pops, but on the back of the PJ doll it says for Pops with an arrow pointing down to the asshole.
Oh, that's...
I know, but the one has a little tattoo on its arm right there, right on his shoulder.
Oh,
his shoulder blade.
That might be
H and Pops or something. I don't know what it is. I gotta look at it again.
It's taint meat.
It's real sentimental. It's for me and Pops only, Jay. Don't worry about it.
They're nice. You'll cherish them forever. However long that might be, but I don't know.
Can you ask him to add that to his will so that if he's buried, that he's buried with those dolls?
No, I get those. And he's getting cremated, don't you? We just went through this an hour ago.
Well, can he at least bring the dolls to the lunch?
Goddamn technically smart. We just talked about him getting cremated.
Can he at least bring the dolls to the free lunch? When we talk about the cremation?
Well, that we should do. I don't know if they'll burn them with them, though. That might be a hazard.
Oh,
he's going to be listening to this shit, guys. He listens to every fucking show. So before I bury myself too deep, let me freaking go.
All right, Jay.
See ya.
I'm rotting in hell right now.
You'll be fine.
Pops, I love you. Just fucking around.
Love you too, Pops.
Love you, Pops.
Them's jokes, Pops.
Kevin's a dick, Pops. All right, see you guys.
Fuck Kevin. He ain't going to your cremation.
That's fucked up, dude. Wow. Well, that was interesting. I don't even know. What?
I got words for the pyramid for you. I don't know if you want to play it or if you just want me to say the words.
No, I'd love to play the pyramid game with you one more time. Yeah.
None of my words have anything. Well, they kind of do. Nah. You're never going to get these.
All right. So it's time for the final round of the pyramid game live on the Kevin Holly Show. And we're going to put 30 seconds on the board. Philbert, are you ready?
Yeah, are you ready is the question.
I'm always ready. Here we go. 30 seconds on the board.
It's small and it's ring shaped.
It's small and it's ring shaped?
Correct.
Cock ring.
No. It's flexible and it can contract.
Sphincter.
Ding, 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 ding.
All right, next question.
Something you catch...
Wait, hold on. Okay, here we go.
Something you can catch from grade school girls. Or in your case, boys.
A statutory rape charge.
Close, but no.
Common cold.
There is no cure for these.
SIDS.
No. If you happen to be on the school playground and you have contracted a case of these, everybody in school will shun away from you.
Herpes.
We're
cooties.
Yes.
Cooties.
Ding, 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 ding.
Woo! 2 for 2. 30 seconds on the board. Question number 3. Here we go.
This is a verb. It's a word that is a verb. Is it a verb? Maybe it's not a verb. It is your favorite word, though.
My favorite word? I don't know. Streaking.
It's kind of like the state of something that might involve the answer to question number 1.
Answer number... Your clues suck.
If you were not in something and then you got into something, you have successfully done this to that thing.
Intercourse.
No. Does that mean that you lost because of music? Stop.
Son of a bitch.
Penetration.
That's what I meant when they said intercourse. I think I should get that. Judges?
No.
Judges say, got it.
Nah.
All right. 3 for 3. Question number 4. Pyramid game. Kind of like this.
I'm going to just simply say it is the technical term for cross-eyed.
Philbert.
No. If one eye is looking one way
and the other eye
is looking the other way,
Debo.
You have a case of...
The wandering eye.
It's a technical term, Kevin. It is the medical term for this. Pops probably knows it.
Macular degeneration.
No.
Cross-eyedness.
No. That's the lay term for it.
Damn it.
Strabismus.
What?
Strabismus.
You wrote down strabismus?
Yeah, I love that word.
Do you know Dominic Strabismus?
No.
Okay. All right.
And lastly.
I can't wait.
If you were to somehow exterminate an entire class of people, this word would be the word that you would use for that if that entire class of people were of a certain sexual persuasion.
Homocaust.
Close, but no. Think in modern terms. Relevant terms that are used today.
Genocide.
So close.
Penicide?
It's already over. Gendercide.
Gendercide.
I made that word up today, by the way, just
damn
for
it.
The show.
Let's kill all the fags.
Gendercide.
Wow, Phil. Way to bring the show down. What happened now? What happened here? Okay, nothing.
I figured you guys did such a good job of it earlier.
Yeah, thanks. So let's do another Facebook save, shall we? Or shall we go through my Facebook? Let's see here. Wow. Yeah. Rita,
dead,
my
dead
mom.
Air. Dead air.
My mom
dead
was in
air
there.
Alert.
Our mom was in there. And she said, are you ignoring me? She said she had all the answers to our questions.
Oh, no. Excuse me. I find that hard to believe.
Yeah, well, you know, it is what it is. So, I do have another story that I'd love to share with you before we call it a night. Should we have a nightcap?
Sure.
Okay, cool. Here we go. That's pretty good, Phil. Oh, man, there's so many. Here we go. This one's perfect. From the USA Today. Okay, now that's a reputable source, right? Police.
Good-looking guy there.
Yeah, he's a handsome. He's like Wolfman Jack. Police subdue a naked man, accidentally lighting him on fire.
Huh?
With a taser? Manitowoc, Wisconsin. Police officers arrested a 32-year-old Manitowoc man Sunday evening for standing in the street without any clothes on.
That's a crime in this country?
Travis Tingler.
He was... And that's our show. Thank you.
He was standing in the middle of the street shouting towards a home at the intersection, and he had a knife and was going to gut people in the house. Tingler told officers he wasn't doing anything wrong. I told him he couldn't be out in the middle of the street with no clothes on, said the officer that arrested him. I asked him about his condition. I noticed he had a dazed appearance, a blank stare, and he was sweating profusely. A sweaty, naked man with a knife. The officer suspected Tingler, who said other people were messing with him and he was calling them out, was impaired by drugs.
I'm going to ask the obvious question that mm-hmm. everybody wants to know mm-hmm. again. Mm-hmm. Was he aroused?
Some things you just don't ask on a radio show, Phil. He told the officer he would be out on the street with no clothes on and that he didn't have a weapon. So I guess he was not aroused. Put the gun down. It's not a gun. So Tingler said he wanted to go to a home on 25th Street. Police instead handcuffed him and, finding a pair of pants on the front lawn, tried to put them on Tingler. You ever try to put pants on a naked man, dude?
I'm still trying to figure out how this results in him getting caught on fire.
Well, police talked to a girl. Officers later found a pocket knife on the front porch of a nearby home, and they also found a bunch of coins and several cigarette butts.
Circumstantial.
Mm-hmm. So police talked to a girl who was holding a baby in the home. She said Tingler was dating her mother, and they had lived in the home for about 2 years. She said he started drinking alcohol 3 hours
hold
earlier.
Hold on a second. Mm-hmm. How old was this guy?
32.
And he's dating this chick who has a baby's mother.
Yes.
Wow.
And they lived together.
I want to see that photo.
They lived together in the home for 2 years. He started drinking alcohol 3 hours earlier and started to act weird, making comments such as, "Stay in the light and never come into the dark.
Don't go into the light.
Stay in the light. Never come into the dark. I'm going to gut you all." That's the stuff he was saying, right? So he threw the glass he had been drinking from into the street, breaking it. And then he took off his clothes and threw them onto the front porch, the girl told police. Tingler refused to get into a squad car and said he wanted to see his kids. The mother came home from work, and police used stun guns to get the man into the police car. Police reported Tingler somehow picked up a lighter during the struggle.
Somehow picked up a lighter.
He's getting tased by like five
cops.
This
guy's resourceful.
Mm-hmm. He's nude. Where was the lighter?
Exactly. The guy's awesome.
So when the stun gun probe hit the lighter, a combination of lighter fluid and electricity from the stun gun caused Tingler's beard and chest hair to catch fire. And look at the photo of him, his mugshot.
Yeah.
Doesn't look like he's got any singed hair at all.
He doesn't look like he's drunk either.
No, he kind of looks like Eddie Vedder with a beard. I don't know. Hold on a second here. Here we go. The officer tried to pat the fire off his body. And Tingler, this is what I don't like, is when they... Your only job is to write your report as a reporter. And then there's an editor, an editing department that's going to go through it, make sure everything's spelled right, punctuation.
Nothing's spelled right anymore.
Dude,
it's horrible.
Police reported Tingler. An officer tried to pat the fire off his body. Whose body? The officer's body? Tingler's
exactly.
body?
Exactly. You know? I find that in like every story written today.
Oh, it drives me insane. So an officer tried to pat the fire off Tingler's body, and Tingler continued to fight even after the fire was put out. He then punched an officer in the face.
He's on fire.
Yeah. An officer used another stun gun on him from 6 feet
away. That's like adding fire to the fire.
Yeah, point blank. And then he fell and hit his head hard on the pavement.
Imagine, by the way, there doesn't seem to be any... Oh, look at the after photo where he's been shaved because of the...
He's all shaved. He looks so much different.
But imagine if they were like just... They didn't do anything. They just told him to stop, drop, and roll. And he's like, I'm fucking nude, man. You know, rolling my balls on the gravel?
Well, the balls roll.
I'm just saying. That's not comfortable.
Roll your balls.
You're on fire, you're in pain, and you're on pavement trying to stop, drop, and roll.
And you're getting tased by
the And you're getting tased, yeah.
Yeah. I mean, they all hit him with it. So, officers...
I gotta say, though, he does look a lot better in that second photo.
I don't know if
that's... Like, I think they might have done him a favor.
Maybe. Yeah, maybe. Officers called an ambulance. Hospital staff said Tingler tested positive for marijuana and had a blood alcohol count of 0.177.
Which is why marijuana should never be legalized. You'll get nude people in the streets playing with lighters.
Getting tased.
Getting tased.
Yeah.
Causing havoc.
So, police are recommending charges of resisting a police officer, battery to an officer, disorderly conduct, and lewd and lascivious behavior. Now,
then again, this guy obviously has some mental problems. Maybe they just completely should have approached this whole thing differently, a.k.a. liberal excuse.
Yeah, I mean, he's equal like all of us, you know? I mean, he needed a safe space is all it was. You know,
it's just misunderstood, man. Come on. Why do you got to go right to the taser?
It's Trump's fault.
Yeah.
Love Trump's hate.
Maybe he likes to whittle with that pocket knife.
Yeah. Maybe he was whittling his wood. You know, that's all.
Did they ever stop to think that maybe it was hot out there and that's why he didn't have any pants on?
Maybe he was on bath salts. You know, people make mistakes. You know? Yeah. So, all right. Dreadlocks are not okay for white people to have, period. What do you think of that?
Oh, God, I don't even want... Let me guess. That white person has appropriated somebody else's culture by having dreadlocks. Blah, 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 blah.
Well, having dreadlocks doesn't mean that you're a racist person. And sure, you may not have meant to piss people off, but that doesn't mean that dreadlocks on white people exist in an anti-race vacuum. Phil. Sure, dreadlocks have appeared at different unconnected parts of the world over time, so you may attribute it to Egyptians or Celtic fairy locks. Look at, there's Justin Bieber with dreadlocks right there. Okay? But, you know, I think, personally, the source of its current popularity is largely due to the life and death of Bob Marley, you know, and the humanist movement. I mean, that's just me talking off the cuff.
Maybe it's just a good look that people like.
We're all humans, Phil. You know,
Why should I not be able to wear my hair a certain way if I think I'm going to look good with that? I mean, come on.
Yeah. Well, I mean, some people are appreciative of the Rastafari movement, you know?
Yeah. Or maybe they just like a good look.
Yeah. Well, also, if you wear dreadlocks because it looks cool, then you're still perpetuating white privilege, Phil, right?
Of course.
Yeah. So you're I mean, essentially, and this is just me off the cuff, but you're.
But if you want to get if you want to do like the Kim Jong-un hairdo, that's cool. That's fine.
Sure. Yeah. There's nothing wrong with that.
Nothing wrong with that.
No, no. But I think that you're perpetuating white privilege and you've chosen to be ignorant of a significant contemporary history, if you will.
White people shouldn't get tans either. Seriously, I mean, think about it.
Yeah, yeah. Well, you heard about Beyonce, the wax museum in New York. The wax figure of Beyonce, they had to recall it and pull
it out. Too light. Too light-skinned.
Yeah, not cool.
She's more red-boned.
Yeah. So, anyway, Phil, if you wear dreadlocks, and this is just my opinion, because you think it symbolizes a humanist ideal, then you've attracted the wrong political meaning to them, and instead you're damaging the anti-oppression movement for which they truly symbolize.
What?
I don't know.
This is the most racist show I've ever been on.
Talking out of my ass, man. So I'm growing dreadlocks, man. What do you think?
I've got... My ass is dreadlocked, dude.
Is it really?
Yeah. Butt puppet. It's pretty good.
It's a butt puppet.
It does Bob Marley impersonations. You want to see?
No, thank you.
You sure?
Uh-huh, yeah.
Okay.
When I worked on the dolphin boat, we had a naturalist, and she had dreadlocks, and she was a
white. Can I ask you a question about that dolphin boat?
Yeah, sure.
Did you guys actually ever see dolphins?
All the time.
Did you ever, like, jump out and swim with one?
That's illegal.
Is it really?
Yeah, here.
Why is it illegal? It's just sea life. It's like walking in the woods with squirrels.
Let me refer
you. How is that illegal? I mean, if you took advantage.
With squirrels?
Yeah. If you took advantage of its, like, blowhole or something, then I could see a problem.
Let me refer you to the NOAA Fisheries Southeast U.S. Marine Mammal and Sea Turtle Viewing Guidelines. Let me see here.
Last time I checked, the oceans were free for me to swim in. And if there's another beast swimming with me, man or otherwise, I mean, I'm in the habitat.
No, man.
If I'm molesting it, then yeah.
Yeah.
Well, we'll just wait while you read that, dude. Go ahead.
Basically, never pursue or follow marine wildlife. Any vessel movement should be...
What if you're doing it in the name of science?
Well, that's different, Phil. Okay, that's not walking in the park with squirrels. That's like going out researching dolphins.
I mean, like those guys that were dragging the shark behind the boat. What if they were doing that in the name of science?
Well, they weren't.
How do you know?
Because I saw the video. They were drunk.
I just want to get Jay mad if he's still listening.
Anyway, going back to the dreadlock story, this girl had dreadlocks, and she was a white girl, and she was a naturalist narrator on the dolphin boat that I worked on. Very cool chick. But she was also a part-time captain on the boat, right? So there were some days when I was the naturalist, and she was the captain. And I would introduce the captain on every cruise as we got off the dock and started down the river. And I would say, ladies and gentlemen, before we get started, I'd like to introduce the crew. And I would say, this is your captain, Barb Marley. Thank you, Barb Marley.
That was a long way for that joke.
That's what I do. I do it for work.
Bobby. Though. Bobby Marley.
Bobby Marley?
B-O-B-B-I. That's a chick name, right?
I don't know, but...
Bobby
Marley? Bobby Pinn?
Next!
Well, I wasn't quite done with the dreadlocks story, but...
Okay. I think we get the drift, though. You're racist, and...
Whoa, what's this? Where's the speaker on this thing? What is that? Oh, that's video of a man getting attacked by an alligator on a golf course.
Comic relief.
Yeah, yeah. All right, here's another great story about fire, Phil. This happened in Tampa. A Tampa woman tried to burn a deputy alive. According to News Channel 8 on your side, a Tampa woman tried to burn this deputy alive. In Tampa, a woman was arrested after she set fire to a deputy's property and tried to burn him alive on the 4th of July. Talk about celebrating. What are you holding there?
I'm just holding a list of words that didn't get done on the $1,000 pyramid that I thought were pretty funny.
Would you like me to quiz you?
No, I'm looking at the words, so you can't quiz me. But I'm just going to read them off here.
Look at that mug.
Remember, ooh, what's on her face?
She started a deputy on fire.
Looks like she took a couple shots to the face herself there.
Yeah, somebody pooped on her.
Kevin's list of words for whoever. Apparently, this was supposed to be all around the subject of male anatomy.
Yeah, you were going to and quiz Pops with these words.
Yeah, I was going to quiz Pops, but we'll just let the listening audience, all two of you,
I'll be Pops. Let's role play.
All right, okay. I got to explain this?
Yeah, whatever. Or you just say them.
Think of this as the semen highway.
The seminal vesicle.
Ding, 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 ding. Yeah,
thank you.
Think of this as the off-ramp to the semen highway.
The vas deferens.
Correct.
Fuck yeah.
If you like bathrooms and you're not a vegetarian, you've probably eaten this before.
What is taint meat? No, I'm sorry.
Close. Bathrooms.
One more clue.
After you eat this, you probably, if you're a normal straight man, probably turn around and vomit into one of the words in this answer.
What the fuck are you saying? I don't even know. I wrote
you down. Missed it. Toilet meat.
What?
Toilet meat.
No, that's taint meat.
If you spell taint, T-I, a bunch of scribbled out letters, and T, then perhaps you're correct. It looks like toilet to me.
That's taint. That's clearly a okay, T-A-I-N-T.
Taint meat. Sorry about
taint
that.
Taint meat. I got it right the first time.
You're right.
Yeah, thank you.
This word proves that men can be milked. When you're about 50 years old, your doctor will milk you by gently feeling
what
this.
What is a prostate?
Correct.
Woo!
And the last word that has to do with male anatomy, which is probably the best word on this entire list.
Mm-hmm. What is glick?
Yes. It actually is the correct word.
Man, I nailed it. I killed it. Those are all mine, though. Oh, hey, why are you throwing stuff at me?
I just thought it was funny that glick made the list.
Yeah, I like to put somebody's name at the end of the pyramid game list. Last week I did pedophiles. I did Jerry Sandusky was a word, Bill Cosby, Michael Jackson, Jared from Subway, and then Homeless Chuck.
Homeless Chuck, yeah. Who's that guy?
I don't know. He doesn't want anything to do with the show anymore.
Eat shit.
I don't know why.
Fuck you.
You're an asshole.
You're an asshole.
Called it.
Fucking jerk. Eat shit.
Anyway, oh man, what has happened to our show?
Yeah, it's gone south. Well, it's probably my fault. I apologize to everybody out there who's tuned out because of me.
No, I wouldn't go that far. It's just, you know, we're in like a weird spot here. Hey, you know what? It's exactly 11 o'clock. Let's end the show. Let's get the hell out of here. The show's
over.
What
about all the other stuff we were going to talk about?
Oh man, we'll have to save that for next week, man. But you can hear us again Friday morning.
It's Jaybird in the morning.
And I'd like to thank all of our IRN Internet Radio Network, IRNBroadcast.com listeners. Thank you, Lionel Nation listeners, for sticking around for our show. And also, everybody on TuneIn, Podbean, Stitcher, SoundCloud, iTunes, YouTube, all that good stuff. Spreaker, The Chat Room, Glick, Captain Buttmunch, Seth Gecko.
There's a skeeter on my Peter. Whack it off.
Thank you, Pops and Jaybird. Philbert, our technical producer, Rob Haas, and everybody else out there in Radioland for listening to The Kevin Holly Show. We will catch you again next Wednesday night at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, live. That's what we do. That's how we do it. Phil, any final words?
Just like to say I love Pops.
Aw, how sweet.
Jay ain't so bad either.
Wow. And I got this warm, fuzzy feeling.
Right. Pops is the shizzy!
On that note, we'll see you next week. Later, everybody. Have a great night.
Kevin's getting tired. It's time to end the show. He really freaking blew. It's end of the Kevin Holly Show.
I'd like to thank you for listening to the Kevin Holly Show. I hope you've had as much fun as we have bringing it to you. It's really been a pleasure. And be sure and get us again next week.
Okay. Bye-bye.